Hello children, very good morning all of you. My name is Nagashri and I am going to teach you EVS. Yes children, today let's start with block 1, my family. Okay children, so as soon as you hear my family, what will you think about or whom will you think about? Yes children, what is a family actually? A family are the members who relate to us. Yes children, so family members means, yes, they are the people who relate to us. For example, father, mother, brother, sister, grandfather, grandmother, uncle, aunts and so on. So they all are family members. Okay, and in this lesson we are going to look at the family of Aisha. Yes, we will know about the family of a girl, of a little girl, okay, named Aisha, and she is 9 years old. How old is she children? 9. Yes, so she is 9 years old, and you know, let's see, okay, whether Aisha will live in a small family or a big family. Yes, so what is a small family? Okay, if a family has only father, mother along with their children. For example, if you are living with your father, your mother, your brother and sister, okay, then it is a small family. Yes, so if you are living with your father, mother, brother, sister, grandparents, then uncles, aunts and their children, who will be your cousins, so on, then it will be a big family. Then it is called a big family. Okay, so now you know what is a small family and what is a big family children. Yes, so you know, small family is known as nuclear family. What it is, kids? Nuclear family. And big family is known as joint family. Yes, so in the, who all are the members of joint family children? In the joint family, who all lives? Yes, parents, grandparents, then uncles, aunts and their children, who will be cousins for us and so on. Then it is a joint family or big family. Then what is a nuclear family? Yes, small family is known as nuclear family. That means if we are living with only our parents and our brothers and sisters, if we have, then it is a nuclear family. So a family can be of two types. One is nuclear family and the other one is joint family. So what kind of family do you live in, kids? So think about it and tell me. Okay, yes, and as I told you, in this lesson my family, we are going to know about, okay, the family of Aisha, a girl named Aisha. She is 9 years old. How old is she? 9 years old. Let's see with whom she lives and who all are her family members. Yes, so look here, Mr. Kumar and Mrs. Kumar. That means Aisha's parents, Aisha's father, his name is Mr. Kumar, and Aisha's mother, her name is Mrs. Kumar. Yes, so she lives with her parents and they have one more son. Okay, yes, they have a daughter, her name is Aisha, and they also have a son. So he becomes brother to Aisha, isn't it, kids? Yes, so even his brother, so Aisha has a brother, even he also lives in that family. And who else lives? So Mr. Kumar's parents, okay, lives in the family where Aisha belongs to. Yes, so they all live together, and Mr. Kumar's parents, okay, relate to Aisha in what way? In which way do they relate to Aisha? Yes, they are the grandparents to Aisha, that is grandfather and grandmother. So Aisha's father's parents are grandparents. to whom? To Aisha. Yes, children. And they also live in her family. So, by this itself, you'll get to know that she lives in a joint family or a nuclear family. Tell me, kids. Yes, she lives in a joint family because her grandparents also lives with them. Yes. And then, who else are there? So, Mrs. Kumar, that is Aisha's mother, has a sister and her name is Lucy. So, Lucy, who is Aisha's mother's sister, is aunt. Yes, she is aunt to Aisha and she also lives with them. Okay, so looking here, okay, just have a look at here. You know what? Mr. Kumar has a brother. Okay, so he is not only son to his parents. He is not the only son to his parents. They have, okay, one more son. And you know, he lives with his wife in Mumbai. Yes, you know Mumbai, Bombay. Yes, there they live. And they are the, yes, aunt and uncle of Aisha. Okay, children, they live in Mumbai and they have two daughters again. And what are their names? Their names are Kareena and Karishma. Yes, children, what are their names? Kareena and Karishma. And Kareena and Karishma's are what to Aisha? Are they sisters to Aisha? Yes, of course they are sisters, but they are cousin sisters. Yes, children, because they are the daughters of her aunt and uncle, right? So, do you also have cousins? So, name them. Think about your cousins' names. Think about your uncles and aunts and how they relate to you. Okay, children, this is an activity for you. So, you have to do this activity as well. I'll tell you how to do, okay? Yes. So, they live in Mumbai. Who all lives in Mumbai? Aisha's aunt, uncle, along with their two daughters lives in Mumbai because only they are living. Okay, Kareena and Karishma are living with their parents, right? So, their family is a nuclear family. Okay, so the family of her uncle is small family, that is nuclear family. But what about Aisha? She lives in a joint family. So now you understood. Hope so you have understood the difference between the small family or nuclear family and the big family or the joint family. Yes, children, very good. So what is a family? Yes, a family is a, yes, a family is full of members who relate to us. Yes, children. So, in one way or the other way, they relate to us. They are the family. And what will family, what is the importance of family? What will they show us? What will they do for us? Yes, you know what? They show us care and love. Yes, they show us love. They care for us. Isn't it, kids? And they do so much of things for us. They do so much of sacrifices for us. They are called the family. We, the family members, will be there for each other, whether it is difficult times or happy times, isn't it, kids? We will go out together for a picnic. Then we go out for shopping together. We go for mall. We go for market. Then what else? Yes, we go out for a party. Do you like birthday parties, children? Yes, then we go out together with our family, isn't it? Yes, and you know what? During festivals, celebrations and all, the other family members who relate to us, for example, our aunts, uncles and grandparents, they all visit us, right? Visit means they come to meet us and we all celebrate together by sharing sweets, by having food together. Yes, children. So, family means we all spend time together while we eat and even while praying. So, There is so much of things to tell about family. You should also think and you should tell about your family, children. Okay? And you know, you should not forget to help your family members. Look here, helping our family is most important because, why? Because fathers will, yes, go out and work for us. They will give us all facilities. Okay, mothers will cook for us. They will take care of us. They will bathe us. They will make us, yes, they will prepare us so many things and they will dress us neatly. Isn't it, kids? We should not trouble our parents. And you know, they will give us good education, good clothes, good food, healthy food. Yes, when they provide us and they do so much of sacrifice for us, even we as kids, we should help them, right? How will you help them? You can help them in cleaning houses by doing small works, okay? Like you have to do your own work. That is also big help to your parents. For example, you have to take care of yourself by taking bath, by wearing clean clothes, then by folding your clothes, yes, by putting on your shoes and socks. So these are the tiny works. If you do it for yourself, then your parents will feel so happy for you. And even for them, so much of work is decreased. Yes, children? It is lessened. And you know what? You can help them when they are sick. What will you do? You should not trouble them. You should take care of them. You should ask them by giving them some water. Okay, you should ask them for if they need anything. And you should ask them for help, right? Yes, you should help them, right, children? So this is how we should help our family and you will make your family members feel happy. They will think, oh, my children are so brave. They are so good. They are so kind. So be kind and good. And then help our elders. So in our family, if we have elder people, yes, elder ones, that is grandparents, we should help them especially because they will be weak, right, children? Their eyes, arms, legs, okay? It is weak. And you know, they can't climb the stairs fast as we climb up the stairs. And they can't do the work as fast as we can do. So, we should help them. And as children, you know what? You should go and give the things to them. If they need water, if they need their glasses, if they need newspapers. Like this, you can do small tiny works for them so that they will find it such a big help. Oh, my kids are helping me. They will feel so happy. And you know what? Grandparents will take us out for a walk. They will tell us nice, good stories. They will advise us by telling what is good, what is bad, what to do, what not to do. Yes, children, they will always be for us to guide us and help us. And in return, we should also help them. Okay? Even if they don't ask, we should go and help them, children. And you know what? We should not make the elder people like grandparents and all, they should not feel lonely. So we should look after them, we should spend time with them, and we should see through that they are not feeling lonely. Okay, children? Yes. So here also, Asha is a very sweet girl, just like you little kids. And you know what? She with her brother, Asha with her brother, helps. Okay, they help their parents, okay, in cleaning the table, yes, in sweeping, and you know, in doing small works like arranging their almirahs and getting themselves dressed up and so on. They also spend time with their grandparents, yes, so that they see through that they are not feeling lonely. And you know what? They ask them to tell stories. They love listening stories. Okay? And you know what? They go out for walk with them. And of course, as I told, they help them also. Yes, children. And you know, Aisha's parents and grandparents feel so happy by looking at Aisha and her brother doing so much of things to them. Even if it is small, small little things that they do, you know, parents and grandparents will feel, oh, it is such a big help for them. Yes, they'll feel so happy. So, family is where we will show love and care for each other. Yes, children. So, I want all of you to read this lesson, My Family. Okay. Turn to page number 10, block 1, My Family. Read the lesson. Okay. Go through the lesson word by word and you will see words in bold. Okay. You should underline those words and practice writing these words at least 3 to 5 times. Okay. Like joint family. Write it 3 to 5 times. Then nuclear family, cousins. So such words which are bold, okay, which are in bold, you have to practice writing in your homework book at least 3 to 5 times. Then after reading the whole lesson, okay, do this activity, complete this. You just read about Aisha's family, underline the names of Aisha's relatives in your content book. So here, as you read, children, you have to underline the names of Aisha's relatives. Okay, so who all are their relatives? Take the help of your parents and do this activity as you read the lesson, as I have already explained. Okay, who all lives with Aisha's, and okay, about Aisha's family and all, you should do it on your own. So, who all live in your family? Write your answer in your notebook. So, tell me something about your family, children. Okay, write it in your notebook. Next, fill in the blanks. Mrs. Kumar is Aisha's mother, right? Mr. Kumar is Aisha's father. So, I have explained it to you. So, read the lesson once again and then complete these blanks. Okay, fill in these blanks. So, next, here, look at Aisha's family, those born first. So, children, I want to show you that this is a family tree. Okay, the family tree, what does it show? It shows about the family members who all are there in our family. Okay, it shows about the members of the family. So, here, the elderly people, okay, that is grandparents, okay, they are the ones who were born first, right? Yes, so they are at the top of the family tree. So, grandfather and grandmother. Then comes, okay, their sons, that is Mr. Kumar and uncle. Okay, and then comes their wives, like uncle's wife, aunt, and then Mr. Kumar's wife is Mrs. Kumar, and so on. So, at last is Aisha and Karan, and here Karina and Karishma, who are Aisha's cousin. That means they were born at last, and hence they are at the bottom of the family tree. Children, I will give you an activity as I told you first. Okay, I mentioned it earlier. You should also prepare a family tree, okay, like this in a chart. Okay, children, of your family, not about Aisha's family. I want a family tree of yours. Okay, I want your family tree. Take the help of your parents and prepare this family tree. And then you have to now fill these, okay, fill these blanks and complete the table given here. Okay, take the help of your parents if you have any doubts, or leave a message in the WhatsApp group, kids. Now turn to the next page. Here, how do your parents help you? How do you help your parents? Write your answers in 2 columns in your notebooks. So draw a table in your notebook like this, and then take the help of your parents, discuss, and then write. Okay, children, you can write 2 points. Okay, yes. And then how do Aisha and her brother help their parents? I will give you notes for this. How do Aisha and Karan show that their family is very important? For this also again I will give you notes. Don't worry. So do this from page 12. And here, why does Aisha like to spend time with her grandparents? That one also I'll give you notes. If you know, then please write it in homework book, not classwork. Why do older people need our help? Okay, this is a worksheet. Why do you think they need our help, children? As I told, yes, they will be weaker than us, right? Because as they get old, as we also get old, we will also become weak. So, we will not have that much strength as we have now. Yes, children? So, that also I will give notes. So, children, I want you to write this. Can you think? Question number 4. Do this. Okay? Can you think of any other ways in which we can help our grandparents? Give 2 examples. If you think that you can help your grandparents in any other ways, okay, other than what it is mentioned in this lesson, so you can write it, you can give any 2 examples. So from page number 13, do question number 4. From page number 12, do question number 1. Okay? And then on page 10, on page 10, children, you have to do all the 1, 2, 3, question numbers 1, 2, 3. And here, on page 11, complete this one, question number 1. So, whichever I have mentioned now, okay, only those questions, write it in your notebook or homework book, okay? Yes, and send it to me as soon as possible. I will very soon be sending and giving you the notes of this lesson, My Family. Thank you, children. Have a good day. Bye.